So I don't invest my time to recap the yesterday's lecture because day before yesterday's lecture actually. Because during yesterday's lecture only I had a recap, but I'm not counting that lecture. So yesterday's lecture though I conducted, but I'm not going to count because only for half an hour I had a discussion with you. Now I'm going to cover the 1.1.2 point. That is the importance of quality concepts from commercial development point of view, from profit point of view. These quality concepts are very, very important, that reputation and all why for is necessary in order to sustain the business, in order to have the growth of the business, in order to have the continuous growth of the business, that quality concepts are very important. And because of these quality concepts, whatever the faults, whatever the mistakes could have been possible, those mistakes we are avoiding. And because of that, a brand or reputation can be developed. And for that, these quality concepts are very important. So which are the main areas due to which we need to talk, we need to discuss, we need to implement, we need to execute these quality concepts that we are going to discuss. The first point is a meeting customer expectations. Means every customer remains with the expectations regarding the service, regarding the product. And because of the expectations, only customer is going to take your product. And once the customer has taken the product and customer remains with the expectation, okay, that product quality will be retained, product quality will be sustained, product quality will be remain. So whatever the customer's expectations are there, those are to meet. And for that, if you have the quality control sector, if you have the regular quality assessment system, then there is no chance that whatever the expectations of customer are there, those will be overruled or those will be neglected or those will not be implemented or followed. So your production will be of that cadre. And that is possible only and only if you are caring for quality concepts. In that, quality control will come and quality assessment aspects also will come and other various terms of qualities also will come. So what is the first point? First point or first importance of the quality concepts? Why for we should study? Why for we should understand these quality concepts? Yes, Swapnali, meeting customer expectations is my first point. And if you remember yesterday, I had a discussion about one standard, international standard. So if that product remains with that mark, various numbers are there. But out of that, one of the number I said to you as a representative example. Yes, what is that mark? What is that symbol? What is that certification? Swapnali had yesterday answered, but number was answered later on. What is that? Which mark? And even during advertisement also, the producer, they do give that mark name. Yes, Swapnali Rishikesh, right. ISO 9001. Various numbers are there. Accordingly, various rules are. Depending upon your products, the various numbers we need to follow. But one of the examples that I told you, ISO 9001. Such kind of the marking. What does it mean that you are fulfilling the... If that mark is there, means it is tested. It come under the proper norms and therefore customer also believe that. It means what? Customer wants the maintenance of the quality. Whatever the desires, whatever the expectations of the customers are there, those we have to meet. And that is possible by means of quality concepts. And therefore I discussed that the first point, meeting customer expectations. Now I am coming to the second point. Pay the attention. Managing reputation in market. The current era is a social media active area. Suppose if I purchase one product from the market and if the quality is good, then also I'm giving the review. If it is bad, then also review may not possible. Many times when bad remains, then if spontaneously reply comes or the reviews do come. Those reviews on the Amazon site is a one thing. But by the way, the WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, which are the social medias are there through which also one can communicate, and fastly communication takes place. If one somebody's remark is there on one product, then that positive or negative remark, that is what communicated. So for that purpose, if you want that positive remark only should be forwarded, then that proper reputation is to give. Means one example I give it to you, a cold drink, a brand name that I do not give, but that cold drink, that the bottle, and in that bottle, if that the expiry date was over, then what was found in that bottle or what was found in that container or that tin. So this is the product. So because of that, what happens? A wrong message goes in the customers or consumers, and it affects the sale. Because after all, it is going to affect the reputation of what the company or the production. So what is expected? Managing reputation in the market. And if you have to manage your reputation, then always you have to pay attention towards the quality. You have to verify quality. It may possible one will think, why should we invest that much amount of money for the testing of the quality as such? That investment is worth rather than spoiling the reputation. Because economic point of view also, if you see, if you do not care for the quality concepts, then the economically also the loss will be there. Growth, forget about that, a loss will be there. So degradation of the business may what possible. So in order to manage the reputation in the market, we need to care for the quality concepts. And the one thread that I told to you, that the current era is a social media active era, where the messages spread very fastly. So therefore, each and every customer and its fulfillment is what the very important. Whatever the market reputation remains, that we have to keep. So we say, okay, that shop is there, it's running from last 20 years, 30 years. So one kind of reputation remains compared to the old brand. The new brand has what, the no reputation. So they have to struggle for the reputation. If they have to struggle for the reputation, they have to maintain the quality. They have to concern, they have to take care for what the quality. So second point I wanted to say, the managing reputation in the market because of the current active social media, about which you can give the explanation. So I want to ask you, what is my second point of the importance of the concepts of quality? Yes, Aliya, managing reputation in market, not making, in market. Yes, Mayur, right, Pratiksha, right. Now pay attention towards, good, all your answer. Pay attention towards the third point, third concept, for which we should care for the quality concepts. The third point is meeting industry standards. So whenever any industrial area remains, that's last time I said the different cadre of the MIDC remains. So whatever the industrial norms remains, right from the waste management to the production. So those norms to be followed properly. If you follow the norms properly, then in government sector also you will be with the proper reputation. Means there will not be any complaints regarding you. Sometimes the police complaints also are what lodged. So all the things that industrialization, industrial growth, there remain some standard, there remain some norms, and those norms are toward the follow. By the way, suppose if you are preparing any cosmetic product, a cream is there or powder is there, you have to take care that because of that, a customer will not suffer. A problem to that customer should not be there. It's a side effect. Individual point of view, side effect means if individually allergy is there, that is not controllable. But in general point of view, suppose if there is a change in the composition, change in the formula, then customer will suffer with that. Means mistakenly industry has, that's one face cream that industry is going to manage and customers are using, and mistakenly it is found that pH is not properly controlled. If pH is not properly controlled, then the side effect will be very adverse. And pH control comes under the quality control unit. Because what the product is, this quality is not properly maintained. So that maintenance of the quality comes under the standards of the industry. So industrial standardization aspect remain. So those standards to be what followed. We need to maintain the industrial norms. For one more, that's an example of the face cream that I given. In food industry, if you consider a milk production, so suppose if you take a milk from the Gokul or Varna or Amul, one of the branded milk that I'm saying, other milk also possible. But if you see their qualities of fat and all the contents, whatever may be the season, they maintain the quality. In reality point of view, whatever the raw material or product that they take, that may not be what of the same quality. But output, whatever they give to us, it remains of the same quality. So they have to maintain the quality. Then you may be the question, how are they managing? Yes, that's a skill. That's a skill means it's a technique. They have the patent. They're doing some additional things over there. So they are investing the money for that. So therefore, they retain what the quality. So once you are with the saying that your product is with this much amount of fat, this much amount of carbohydrate, these ingredients are there, then those ingredients should be there regularly. Only for printing purpose, it is not expected because it comes under the standard norms of the industry. So what are the norms of the industry are there? Norms set up by the government. By the way, norms set up by the higher authority, that's the management that we say as a quality. So all the norms to be made properly. If those are not made properly, and if you're finding that the milk from the Gokul or the Varna or the Amul, that's the quality now is less, then suddenly the message will go. Reputation will be, competition is there. So customer will shift to the other company. So for that, the maintenance of the quality, concept of the quality, care for the quality is important in order to meet the norms, in order to meet the standards of the industry. So I want to consider now the third point as meeting industry standards. It is expected. So what is the third point? Why for the concept of quality we need toward the study? Yes, for the purpose of meeting industry standards. Yes, right. Yes, good. All you are what answer. Now the fourth point that I am discussing. Just wait, somebody wanted to enter. The fourth point is variability of materials. Means just now I said the food industry, that's a say milk industry, whatever the raw material that a company gets, by season wise also it varies, and you take any season, area wise also it will vary, or the production wise also vary. Means the milk that they take from the various farmers, that not necessarily of the same fat or the same grade, but ultimate product they have to prepare the same. So raw material may vary, but because of that output or the production is not expected to vary. If you take a chips, a Lay's or the Kurkure, that's the packets. So whatever their quality is there, they are using the masalas. Different, say they are using the chili. Then the chili powder also may not be of the same quality. So if the raw material changes, then accordingly they have to change. So for that they have to taste what is the strength, that chilliness or the pungentness of that the chili powder or other masala products also you can think. Even the raw material, other raw materials, a potato if they are taking, then potato standard also may want a different. So while choosing the potato before processing, they have to see whether that potato is of the suitable norm or not. Other, if you say the poha industry, poha means that's in English what to say, I don't know. Yes, anybody knows the name, what to say for poha? Will anybody guide me? Which rice?
Flattened rice.
Who is saying?
Ismail.
Ismail. Flattened rice. Okay. Flattened rice, roasted rice. Okay, whatever you say. Rice flakes. Okay, Poonam. Okay, you say good. Your answers are important for me. Rice flakes you consider, flattened rice you consider, that its quality also will vary right up upon the. It depends upon raw material, that's the input material. So which kinds of input material to be what given, that also to be what they decided. So whatever may be that, but accordingly overall quality of the manufacturing is not expected to change, not expected to vary, that care to be able to. So variability of the material may be there. But if variability of multiple is there, the output will vary. If output varies, the quality will vary. So if it is not to vary quality concepts, if quality concerns are there, quality management is there, quality control is there, quality assessment is there, then the reputation can be maintained, then the quality of the output can be what maintained. Means whatever the necessary things are there to change the desirable aspects, you will care for that and you will make a change so that the quality will be retained. So if rice changes over there, the time necessary, duration necessary for the, that's a roasting, may what the vary. So that changes in your manufacturing you will do if you are with the quality concern. If you know the quality concept, you are following the quality assessment norms. Weather conditions also do change. And by changing the weather condition, if you have not paid the proper attention, if you are not following the proper norms, then the output or the production quality will change. So that considering weather conditions, considering in a raw material, even if quality changes, your production quality is not expected to change. Especially the natural products, that's the milk that I said, or even vegetables, you consider the variations, considerable variation in the quality remains. But ultimate variation should not be there. Same thing in the mangoes also. The canning industries many remain with. So ultimately the quality is to be what sustained, quality is to what remain. So if the variation in the raw material is there, certainly the output will change. If it is changing over there, then the reputation, quality concern, all these are problem. But if you are caring for the quality aspects, then the your industry will run what the properly. So in order to have the good profit or in order to have a growth in the industry, you need to consider the variability of the materials. Even if material vary, your result is not expected to what the vary. Your output is not expected to vary. So why for you should pay the attention towards concept of the qualities? Because input material may be varying. Not only the material, your machineries also, because of the regular use, there remains some kind of the less efficiency in the machine. So if the efficiency decrease, then also you have to pay the attention towards that. Therefore, why what we said, maintenance and calibration of the calibrations is very important. So when it comes under what? It comes under the quality concepts. Therefore, you have to pay variations because of raw material, variations because of the machineries that you are using. That may what the possible and that variation, if you consider, then production will be at proper, means quality concepts are important. So the fourth point that I wanted to discuss is, yes, will anybody reply? Variability of materials, is raw material, machinery material, everything you can what consider. Very good, very good. All are answering. Now the fifth point that I am discussing, that's a customer satisfaction. Meeting customer expectation is one thing. And now I'm talking about what the customer satisfaction, so that you will get repeat business. And if customer is satisfied, then customer will communicate to others. That's a publicity that we say. Word of mouth from one person to other person. The publicity can be increased, and because of that, brand setup may what the possible. So for that, we need to get towards the customer satisfaction. Expectation is one thing. Because customer doesn't know many times to expect what exactly and to what extent. Little ideas do remain. But suppose customer, you deliver this product in such a way, customer is so happy. Customer said, okay, I was not expecting that this much I will get from this much amount of money, this much amount of investment. It means customer is most happy, beyond expectation. If the product is going to satisfy customer, then customer remains what the more happy. Therefore, we need to take care for customer satisfaction, and customer satisfaction care can be taken in quality control aspects. And for that, we need to study these quality control aspects or quality concepts. So these quality concepts will take care for customer satisfaction. Again, I am saying customer expectation and customer satisfaction, these two different things are there. At the beginning, customer remains with some expectation, but beyond expectation, if you could give anything extra, therefore in advertisement also they do give, no? See, this much extra is given, extra is given. So this emotionally that customer gets what the influence because of that extra quantity that I got. So worth to my investment, worth to the amount that I'm going to spend, I am getting the rewards, I am getting what the results. So customer becomes happy. If customer is happy, then campaigning or the advertisement may what the possible. And for that, a care or concern of the quality is what the important. If you care, then the customer will be what? Satisfied. So that was my fifth point of the explanation. Yes, what was the fifth point of explanation? Yes, right. Now, sixth point, that is very important one. Good. All you are answering. Brilliant. Is forecast liability. Means what? Few production, what they remain at that time, what they thought over there. Let customer purchase that. Afterwards, what? There will not be any problem. But many times, problem comes later. A customer, if not satisfied, can sue that company in the court. Means court cases may possible. Complaints may what possible. And if that complaints are there, then in order to struggle against that concept, again, the investment, judiciary and all investments means what? That's to fight a case, the investment will be there. So more money will be spent. If more cases are there, more complaints are there. So it is what the loss that indirectly that company may what suffer. So company should take at the beginning only care that in future such liabilities, in future such problems will not come, especially food industry or few where what the machinery safety point of view, they have not cared, care is not taken, but company guarantees that safety point of view, those things are there. As for example, if you take any car, in car if an accident takes place, then it is expected that that's one balloon should not expand, means when the large impact occurs on what the car. But if that balloon doesn't work, then it's a manufacturer fault, company or commercial problem. So only repairing that, it is not there. Extra fine remains, heavy fine remains on what the company, heavy claim remains to the company, and for there a considerable loss occurs. So considering future aspects in order not to have those problems, at the beginning only let you conduct those things. Let you see whether the problems will not come in future. Let you be the any machinery manufacturer or let you be any food product manufacturer. Food poisoning cases you might have heard. If such thing occurs, and then manufacturer will be responsible. If if it is found that manufacturer responsible, then a heavy fine remains. It is not so recent, but you might be knowing that's a Maggie. One pollutant was there. Maggie poisoning was there. That's Maggie poisoning because of which heavy metal, maybe before 5-6 years, this issue was run. Right, Swapnali. Yes, I am expecting further two answers. Yes, Ganesh. Right, Amisha. Yes, further answers. Only three came. Okay, good. You are answering now. So lead poisoning, lead content was more. So that is not tested. It is to be what tested regularly. It is not following the norms of the industry. So future threat came to that company. Many reasons may possible, other competitors also can raise whatever they may do over there, but if they are proper at their level, then this problem will not come. For that purpose, the quality concern, quality concepts implementation is very important in order to avoid the future liability, or it is said as forecast liability. Forecast, what in weather you might have heard, what the forecast means. Now rain, heavy rain will be there tomorrow, or lightning will be there, or light rain will be there, whatever the forecast, they predict. Means in future that may be possible. In order to avoid such threats in the future, in order not to happen such things in the future, at the beginning only we should take care for this quality concepts. So quality concepts are important for forecast liability. Yes. What is the sixth point? Just now I said, yes, forecast liability. And now the last point that I discuss for which we should care for the quality, that is reducing cost. See, it is not easily digestible at the beginning, but if you are the perfect industrial business one, then you will understand it is worth to spend money in the quality management, in the quality control, in the quality assessment, rather than negligence. Because if you neglect the quality assessment regularly, then what will happen? After a lot of production, you come to know, oh, this material is spoiled one, is not correct. Means if any food material, food product that you are what preparing, and you have prepared a huge food product, large food product, and later on you have found that's the ingredient that you are using, it is not fair, it is not proper, it is wrongly used, then what will happen? Whatever the production that you did, that is what the wastage. Means at home also such thing may not possible, even in industrial sector also such thing happens. So after production, and you come to know the wrong thing that you have used or improper thing that you have used, rather than if you would have followed the quality concern, if you have followed the quality assessment, then regularly there remains a verification, regularly there remains a checking, you would have what not committed that mistake. To make this concept clear, I give you the example that in multi-step experiment, means gravimetric analysis, if you consider, then you come to know, oh, I had not followed that thing. Means I have filtered the precipitate, but not washed the precipitate. Suppose if experiment is there, 50 cubic centimeter, the solution you have to pipette out. During pipettation, you pipette out, because you remain in the one world, you pipette out the solution. But pipette one, that pipette is of 25 cubic centimeter, two times you have to pipette out. But what you did, you pipetted only one time. And afterwards you conduct experiment. And when you come to know the product, when you come to know the precipitate, then you find that your precipitate is less compared to the others' precipitate. Nearly all are with the good quantity of precipitate, your precipitate quantity is less. Then you come, go on thinking, what may be the mistake? Then you realize, oh, there are 50 cubic centimeter I have to pipette out, but I pipetted only 25 cubic centimeter, only 50% solution. Yes, Chetan, you raise the hand. Any question? Chetan, hand was raised, therefore I asked the question.
No.
Okay, mistake only it may be raised. Okay, doesn't matter. So I was saying, and afterwards you come to know this mistake takes place, then many times what happens, it be whatever your efforts are there, those are waste. Efforts are wasted, but what the chemicals that you have taken, those also will be the waste. No, in order to get accuracy, I'm saying, to understand concept, okay, but in order to get the accuracy, industry, such things are not expected to follow. So if these things are there, then considerable loss will be there in future, complete production will be spoiled. Sometimes they have to throw that complete production in terms of batches it remains. Then that's a loss. Why for it is going to occur? Because their quality assessment system, quality control system is not fair. And therefore these problems are coming. And loss will be there. So in order to avoid the loss, so my last point is what the reduction of cost. Cost means the production cost I am talking about. Otherwise, if loss is there, then you will not come in the loss, then you will increase the that's a value of that product or the cost of the product. If cost value is more, then again the purchase and everything gets sort of affected in future. So that quality aspects are the very important. Therefore, if you visit in industry, then you will find they pay a very, very proper intention, attention towards quality aspects, quality assessment. So that's the importance of that. So what is the last point that I said? Yes, Ganesh, reducing costs. Aliyah, right, right. Now, one by one, let us revise. The today's point was this much only. So I had covered the 1.1.2 importance of the concepts of the quality. I want answers from you one by one. Everybody should reply. Now, how many students are there? 20 students are present here. I am waiting for your replies now. Today, I discussed the importance of the quality concepts. In that, what is the first importance? Why far should we follow the concepts of quality? We should study the concepts of quality. First point. Yes, Neha. Yes, Aliyah. No, Neha, reducing cost is old one. Aliyah, right. Meeting customer expectations. Satisfaction that one. Customer expectations. Right. Everybody is going to answer. Very fine. Second point. Meeting reputation in market. Yes, Mayur. Aliyah, right. Third point. Yes, Puna, meeting industry standards. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. I bring your answers also so on record. Just wait. So now my other record was there. Now those will come on what the actual record of the screen, what you are answering. Yes, what is the third point of importance? Meeting industry standards, okay, I said, okay, afterwards, right. It's a fourth point actually, I was wrong. Variability, not variability of materials. I think mistake is there. right. Fourth point is a variability of materials. Right. Fourth point is the variability of materials. Now, fifth point, customer satisfaction. Right, Ganesh, Ismail, Shruti. Right. Customer satisfaction. Sixth point, forecast liability. Ganesh, Puna, Malia. Right. Forecast liability. Right. Seventh point, yes, Aliya, Ganesh, reducing cost. You can say what the cost. So it's a better cost. Yes, students, I'll give the PDF. Give me half an hour. Within half an hour, I will provide the PDF there, and the recorded lecture you will get what the maybe by evening before 7 o'clock you will get the recorded lecture. Yes, any question that we have discussed the 1.1.2 of the syllabus? I want to know from you, shall I conduct tomorrow lecture? Okay, this no answer is for what? Shall I conduct lecture tomorrow? No. Okay, for lecture you are talking about, no. So tomorrow will be what, the holiday then? Okay, now shall I stop? Okay, today's lecture number, just wait, what is that number? It is a 5. Yesterday, don't count yesterday's lecture. 5. I repeat, do not count yesterday's lecture. So it is a 5. Am I right? Yes. So yesterday, though I conducted, I am not counting that lecture. So today's the lecture 5. Okay, students. So tomorrow I am not going to lecture. Yesterday, don't put attendance. In case if you put attendance, leave it. Don't put yesterday's attendance. Yesterday only half an hour I conducted, and thereafter I could not complete the topic or the point which I was with expectation. Now I completed that. So students, I declare here today's lecture is over. You can quit now.